Hello, my name is Scott Detray, assistant principal at Brecksville Robbie Heights High School. I serve students' last names L to Z, and I want to talk a little bit about our attendance procedures specific to the high school. As in previous years, we do ask that you notify the school if you know your child's not going to be attending for the day. There are two phone numbers printed on the screen here that we ask that you store and keep readily available and notify us in the event that your child will not be attending school. We do ask that we have those phone calls in before 8 a.m. You can call anywhere through the night, leave a message, and we'll make sure that we get that documented through the course of the day. This will save you from getting a return call from us later that morning as we're trying to track down where your son or daughter might be. If we don't get a note or don't have a phone call, it does go in as an unexcused absence for that day. And the other tricky one that we're going to have this year to maintain is the fact that even though half the school might be a hybrid or a remote learning for the day, we're asking that if your child's not going to participate during that day from home, that you also call in with a sick or I have an appointment type note. This way, we can clarify that attendance record as well, because we are going to be taking, students are going to be asked to maintain their schedules even on the days that they're not in person here at the school. So daily attendance will be taken remotely through their participation in the class or an activity for that class period all day long throughout their schedule. So if they miss any one of those marks or check-in points, that'll trigger something for us to notify you that so-and-so may not have been online or participating. So are they sick or is there something that's happening? Tardies, school at the high school starts really early, 7:35. We know that you can get here at that time. If you're not here by 7:35, we ask that you will enter through the front door. We'll scan in at the main office. Everybody will have an ID card or a student ID number that they can carry with them to help facilitate the scanning in the main office to get you to class as fast as possible. And so hopefully everybody's here on time. Our buses do get here on time. If you're getting dropped off, you can get dropped off at either the auxiliary gym door or the main auditorium entrance. Those are both places that also will let you in, but at 7:35, you have to come, after 7:35, you have to come in through the main doors. If a tardies become an issue, they will begin the consequence ladder after the third one each quarter, and consequences may be issued for repeated tardiness to school. We know that from time to time, planned doctor's appointments may come up or things come up. If you have appointments, we would like them to be known in advance. Please call the attendance line, again, at those numbers, or send in a note and have them stop by the attendance office in room 133, and we'll make sure that we get a planned absence form or document that properly. Anytime a student leaves for those doctor's notes, we ask that you leave also through the main office and you would scan out of the building. So like tardies and early dismissals, if you scan in and out, then we know who is in the building at any time and who is not in the building. And so as a parent, if you'd like to call and help us with this, that would be appreciated. So